Superlist sounds like something that they would say if they were calling out what the name of the product is. Superlist is a product that is essentially like the next iteration of Wonderlist. For those of you that are familiar with that app, it is tasks, notes, and everything in between. If you go through their website, I'd say it's a pretty cool platform. They have a lot of different capabilities that I think you will enjoy. First of all, like I said, this website's got it all. I mean, look, this is hot. If you wanted an ad for a video on the website, I don't know how they actually managed to make this like a full screen sort of ad, but they did a really good job. Whoever's in their marketing department needs all the money. That's great. And before we dive into it, I just want to acknowledge the fact that there is a free version to try out to get started, and you actually have unlimited tasks, notes, and reminders, unlimited private lists, and 5 shared lists with up to 5 people. And there's integrations with Gmail, Google Calendar, Microsoft To Do, and email forwarding, as well as email task summarization, and up to 10 megabytes of upload and 500 megabytes of file storage. Whereas you get the pro version, they also add Slack, GitHub, Linear, and Figma integrations, and AI list creation. And if you are a team, you have up to 5 team members for free and 15 shared lists between team members. Whereas the pro team ends up also having the personal pro version added to every team member, and you have unlimited shared lists with team members and guests. So let's try this out for the Mac, as I am a wonderfully unbiased Mac user. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to sign into my Google account and open up the application, make this bad boy full screen. And you'll notice pretty quickly this has a similar setup to a lot of products. What I do find interesting is the fact that it has these like pretend scribbles over here to the side. But this is the inbox where you can manage all new and incoming tasks. So if I press Command N, apparently it will create a new task, and I can say take out the trash and say tomorrow. And it does have natural language processing. As you'll notice, this will pop in. And if I type hashtag, it'll create a new label. So I could do chores, for example. And if I press enter, it's a new task on my list. Now, this can be assigned to me or it can be assigned to others. So if I invited somebody, I would have the ability to add them and then assign them. And if I click on this, it opens the task details. And I will say this is a nicer user interface experience than something like a Todoist when it comes to the subtask sort of thing. It's definitely like a larger area. So in subtask, you have the same thing. For example, like grab recycling is part of it, and then grab trash are two different parts of it. So if I go back here to my inbox, you'll notice that if I had made this task today, it would be in my today view. And then when I go to tasks, you'll see that not only is that main task popping up here, but all 2 subtasks are popping up here as well. I have the ability to check this off as the main one, and it doesn't check off the ones below it, which I do find interesting. Some applications are a little bit wishy-washy on that. Now, I checked it off and I'm trying to press Command Z, which is a pretty natural, like going back and making sure that you can undo something, but it doesn't seem like I can. So what I can do here, which is interesting, is I can group this by creator, assignee, alphabetical, like I can group it by list, which is like the getting started item versus the no list. And you'll notice here, this little list is, for example, the getting started page. Now, how do we make a list, for example? That's something that we have to work through in this section. So you can add sections and create lists. So for example, if I want to do recurring chores as a section, then I add this task list, for example. I can say gross chores, and I can do take out the trash every Wednesday. So then I would do weekly on Wednesday. And you'll notice if I click here, the recurring tasks are pretty similar to that of other daily planner apps. But what makes this different is not only does this task occur, but I do have the ability to check it off. And then next week it'll pop up right here. And say for example, was today. Once again, it would pop up in my today view, which is great, and it would be under the list gross chores. And if I wanted to group it by the list, I absolutely could do that. And another option that's interesting is if I click on the 3 dots here, I can press unsubscribe, which I believe basically gets rid of notifications for that coming through. And in order to mark things as incomplete, you would click on the 3 dots here and mark all as incomplete. So what's frustrating to me about this experience so far is that we have, if I go through the back buttons, the ability to find that task, right? So if I press mark all incomplete, it doesn't actually uncheck this. I can click on this and this and then mark all incomplete. And then it would do it, but the main one doesn't get marked as incomplete, which is a little bit confusing to me. But what is great is the fact that when I click on this, I actually have the ability to do something that goes above and beyond just task creation. You'll notice this when I'm clicking here. Obviously, there's the new task and everything like that. But if I go to a list, for example, I can take some notes. I can change this emoji to be like writing, like a pad or something, a pen. And then you'll see add tasks or type backslash to choose a different type of content, which is absolutely true. I can do backslash and then do a H3 and type out a section here. I can do another slash and there's a divider. It looks more natural, like a line someone would draw, but that's something that can be changed. If I click on this and adjust it, I can do a paragraph text, so I can literally just type anything I want out. And then you'll notice when I press enter, it kind of goes in line with that as the next thing is a paragraph. And then we can just press enter and it would go through the next thing as that same style. So for example, if I were to make a task here and then I would type out a task and then press enter, you'll see the next line in the break ends up being a task. So it kind of continues that same option. Now, what would be great about this is if I could select multiple of them by clicking and dragging, or by even pressing a command or control to grab many of them. But instead, what it seems like I can do is I can actually grab all of these like this and press delete. So it does work in a similar way, but you can't grab from the outside, which makes it look like you can't grab from the inside, at least from someone who has a lot of experience using these markdown type things. And you might be asking the question, does this have markdown capability? The answer is yes. If I do two brackets in opposite directions, that would make a task. If I do a bullet point, that would make it. If I do a hashtag, it would make a header. If I do nothing, it would be a paragraph. If I do three, it would be heading three. If I do two, it would be heading two. If I do three lines, it doesn't do a divider, but there might be something I'm missing. Numbered list, same thing. So it is markdown, a little bit of forward slash functionality. A lot of what you'd experience in something like a Notion is here, mixed almost with like your Todoist experience. And on top of that, the integrations are cool, right? I just want to showcase the entire list here. So for example, create calendar events from Superlist tasks with due dates. Gmail is another option here. So if we add my Gmail account, and you'll notice here, it gives me the option to automatically create a task when I star an email or mark an email as important, or I add a Superlist label to an email. And another thing that it can happen is I could add task summarization. So turn emails into actionable tasks and summarize the email. By enabling this feature, you agree to our privacy policy amendment. And you also have the ability to archive an email or do nothing or delete an email when Superlist creates a task from an email. And after I mark a task as done, I like the ability to archive an email. I think that makes sense. So say I were to star this email by pressing this right here and I go to my inbox, it says you've got one credit, and you'll notice there's a clickable open to that email, which is essentially just Audible telling me I have the ability to purchase another item. And I wish this existed for things like Notion and other daily planner apps like Todoist, for example. If I had just basic Todoist tasks and added it like that, that'd be awesome. So these integrations are great. It adds the entire context from the email here for the most part. Other integrations, as you can see, include Microsoft To-Do. So keep Microsoft To-Do lists and tasks in sync with Superlist. Creating calendar events from Superlist tasks with due dates makes sense for time blocking. Although we don't really have a like calendar view at all. It's more of a list and note-taking view. And then from there, create Superlist tasks from Slack messages. This makes a lot of sense for people who get requests from Slack. Totally can see how this works. Turn linear issues into Superlist tasks, GitHub, Figma. All of these are solid. I will say, I do think that if this integration list was larger, I'd consider it more. As a huge Slack and Gmail user, I could see already it being very applicable for some members of my team. However, I don't think it's quite there for me to recommend it for large teams. So if you're interested in this product and want to try it out, do give it a try. I think it's a nice mix between a note-taking app and a task management tool that has solid integrations. I'm curious to know what your thoughts are on this in comparison to other tools that are sort of daily planners, sort of to-do list task managers. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below, and let me know your thoughts on this video on how to improve your skills using tools like this even more.